Hello, I'm Maha. Welcome to my channel, Maha's Musings, where today I'm going to be doing a book review on The Girl with the Paisley Dupatta and Other Stories by Mavish K. Motadullah. This book was given to me by my friend Aisha, Humayun Khan. Thanks a lot, Aisha. And I read it with a lot of curiosity. It's a collection of short stories which are mostly women-centered and also on minority communities. She has given a voice, a platform to those who are unheard and marginalized within society. And also at the same time, given a voice to those who have been treated with some form of prejudice or bias from within their communities, families, and also turned it within themselves. Mavish is somebody who describes herself as a corporate nut absconder. She's someone who lives between three countries, Pakistan, Dubai, and Sri Lanka. And these story settings are also reflected within the stories. Now, in the first story, The Sins of Our Father, it starts off pretty staid and conventional, and then it goes into a very disturbing territory and with a lot of shock value. So, yes, stories within this book have shock value, they're ironic, and yet at the same time, they're also familiar. In this one, I was not familiar with the concept of revenge rape in The Sins of Our Father. And as the writer says, she talks about lives outside the bell curve, you know? So stories that are outside the bell curve of our lives. And this revenge rape was very much part of that. It was very disturbing to the senses. Another story, which is the title story, The Girl with the Paisley Dupatta, has to do with in-family marriages, arranged marriages, which are very uncomfortable and faced with certain situations. But in this one, there's a plot twist which redeems the heroine and saves her from a torturous marriage. I really liked that. I like how the heroines within the book, right, the protagonists within the story, are not portrayed as somebody who have to live through their stigma. Some of them make choices that go beyond that. You know, they decide to defy the conventions of society and within the community in order to survive and in order to have peace of mind. And I really liked, you could say, these twists within the story. They did things which were unexpected and which were frankly very welcome. Now, some of the themes within the book have to do with minorities, authoritarianism, patriarchy, stigma, inherent bias, questionable professions, prejudices, and unconventional role models as well, I would say. So all these run like a thread within the short stories. So what are the pros to this book? Well, one of the pros to this book has to do with how patriarchy is on side by side with irony. You know, the irony of patriarchy. Take a look at this. He was still young enough to consider his sisters as more than just temporary appendages. So this is from The Sins of Our Father, and context matters. It's based in rural Sindh, and this young boy is going to be expected to grow up in a certain way, which the closeness with his sisters is no longer going to be natural, you know, for him, unfortunately. This other story called Love in Rawalpindi, there's humor in that, and I really liked that. Humor is something that's very important for me. One of my favorite short story writers, Anton Chekhov, I love his style of writing. It has humor interspersed with it, and this particular story had some of that. Again, the irony and patriarchy come together, but it's redeemed by this. Tailors in the Islamic Republic are trained to observe from afar and can get a lady's measurements pitch perfect from a handful of wary, discreet glances at her dupatta clad body. Now, so a dupatta is like a veil that covers a woman's body, modesty. So this is what the writer is referring to, you know, the expert eye of the tailor in Islamic countries. I also liked how she addresses shapes. You know, the protagonists are women and characters of different sizes, temperaments, age groups, and shapes as well. There is this one particular character who is very girly. She's like a girly girl, and she's very larger than life. Physically, she's an ample figure, but she considers herself very dainty and feminine, which just stood out in my mind because she's just so real. You know, you can imagine you've encountered such people. But her heart was bound in ribbons of old world romance that fluttered around her ample stature at all times. Then there are also very flawed characters, you know, who have a lot of inherent biases. Like there's this one lady, I think her name is Tabassum. She's from the story called "A Jazbe Dil Ghar Mein Chahu." Oh, valiant heart, if I so desire. That's what it translates into English. She's very anti-Malala Yousafzai, the girl who won the Nobel Prize, you know, who was shot in the head by the Taliban. This lady is very anti this girl. And she's like a metaphor for a lot of people who hate on other women, women hating on other women. And it's about their own restrictions, their own suppression, their own inability to feel that other people have not recognized their potential, so they sort of take it out on somebody else, even this young girl who has been recognized by the larger world for her courage and bravery. So it's about that, and it's very nicely written. I also like the story of Eustace Shergill about a single father from the Christian community, and also the story about the gods of fury, about Hindu mother and the aspiration she has for her child, and how she sees that all unraveling when he's accused wrongly, and how her world starts to fall apart from within. And you could reverse this and write about a minority woman from another country, you know, belonging to another country, and her trials and tribulations within that country, you know. So it could be like minorities from different faiths living in different countries. It's all very universal. It's all very interchangeable as well. So what are the cons to this book? Well, one of the cons to this book has to do with the fact that some of the writing is very wordy and the themes were a little dreary and dark, but realistic enough. You know, I prefer humor. Yes, I admit I read for pleasure. I like to read stories that have to do with wit and humor more than tragedy and sordidness. But having said that, since I have my own book club and since I've gone into writing book reviews for a while now, I've become much more open to new genres, and I welcome that. And it's given me a lot more understanding of what writers want to express and write about, and I appreciate that. So yes, I would give this book a 4.5 stars. Why? Because she has portrayed the sordid experiences of protagonists in a way that offers a portal or an alternative reality to a different realm, which is more fulfilling in this book. Now, whether that's realistic or whether that's believable, you have to decide for yourself. Is it or isn't it realistic? You be the judge of that. Thanks so much for joining me today. I really appreciate your comments whenever you make them. Please subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already. And I'm also on Instagram, where I write my book reviews. I'm also on Goodreads as well. Once again, thanks so much. Until next time, have a good weekend. Bye for now.